Hello, welcome to my channel. Today we're back at soap making and we'll be making some liquid soap. Let's start by dissolving our potassium hydroxide into distilled water while the oils are heated in the crockpot at warm setting. Potassium hydroxide dissolves differently in water when compared with sodium hydroxide and may make a crackling sound when you add it in. The amount you need will depend on the oils you choose and the purity of your potassium hydroxide. Make sure to take both of these into account and run it through a light calculator before making your soap. Unlike the liquid soap with high percentage of coconut oil I've made previously for household cleaning, this recipe has more olive oil, canola oil, and sweet almond oil for their moisturizing properties. The full recipe is down below in the description box for your reference. Other useful links are provided for your reference as well. This soap recipe will go through all the cooking stages and you'll be able to see the changes that takes place when the soap transforms. The soap paste texture will also be different where it is much softer. After the light solution turns clear, you can pour the solution down the shaft of the stick blender to avoid splashes. Turn on the stick blender and blend well. The soap may look like they are separating but just keep stick blending. From this point onwards, there will be a lot of stick blending. Basically just keep going until it's too thick to stick blend. This time I've made some changes to the liquid soap recipe that I usually use. Instead of sunflower oil, I substituted it with canola oil and sweet almond oil because I didn't have enough sunflower oil. I originally wanted to make a full olive oil liquid soap, but I didn't have enough olive oil as well. Other oil substitutions for olive oil you may choose to use to create a clear soap also include rice bran oil, camellia seed oil, and avocado oil. But I think I prefer this formula because it released less of a cooking oil scent while cooking, and the finished soap was much more nourishing for my skin. If you choose oils with high unsaponifiables such as shea butter and jojoba oil, they should not exceed 5% of the formula, or your soap won't turn out to be clear. Some people like to use a bit of palm oil to push the soap to trace a bit faster, but I don't think that's necessary. Soap recipes like my previous video ran through the stages much quicker and it skipped through some of the stages if you go back to that video. 6 minutes into stick blending, you can see that the soap has reached the first stage of thick applesauce stage. Then after 3 minutes, the soap turns thicker and into the stage of cooked custard with small bubbles. After another 7 minutes, the soap turns into the watery, mashed potato stage. Keep stick blending and don't give up just yet. The soap then transforms into the solid taffy stage. This is the transformation that I find the most amusing. Pretty much keep stick blending and this is usually the stage where you can't really stick blend anymore. Switching to a spatula, mix the soap paste well and turn the crock pot on low and start cooking. Come back to check and stir the soap paste every 15 minutes. When the soap starts cooking, it basically slowly turns into the chunky or creamy Vaseline stage. If you go back to my previous liquid soap video, the soap paste with high percentage of coconut oil is much harder and less chunky. This formula is a lot softer and creamier. Keep checking on the soap every 15 minutes. I have planned to cook this soap for 2.5 hours. In the meanwhile, I had a great time reading 12 Rules of Life by Jordan Peterson. Share me your thoughts on reading by clicking on the poll and leave me any comments if you have any book recommendations. Remember to stay close and watch out on your crockpot in case any volcano eruptions does happen. As you can see, the soap does expand a bit and volcanoes can happen. After 2.5 hours, the soap looks done and I've dissolved some of the soap in water and had a clear solution. But I prefer to cook it for a bit longer, maybe for another half an hour to an hour. Then that night I had dinner out, so I turned the crock pot off and covered it with a damp cloth. Coming back to the pot after 5 hours, uncovering the pot, the soap has actually turned into the translucent Vaseline face, looking completely done. Using the dissolved soap solution and testing the pH, the soap is ready. Since it's already cooled, I usually package them in Ziploc bags and dissolve the soap paste as I go. This way I can control the concentration of the soap accordingly and save storage. You can always go back to my previous video to find out the different ways to dissolve the soap paste. Thank you for watching and don't forget to subscribe for more videos.